this is a beginning of a series on water and how it relates to HVAC and how we do things in HVAC. Water has the holds the position of the highest specific heat of any substance on Earth. Now, what does that mean? It means simply, and we're not going to get really complicated into how specific heat's done and so on, it takes more heat to heat water than any other substance. So if I have a pound of water and I have a pound of alcohol and I heat them, it takes more heat to raise the temperature of water than it does of alcohol. So why does that make a difference to us? Well, let's kind of look at what water does in this world. Okay, 70% of the mass of the Earth is covered with water. I would call it the great temperature equalizer. If it wasn't for water having such a high specific heat, the Earth would get much hotter and much cooler. So when the sun would shine, it would get much hotter, and when the sun went away, it would get much cooler. You notice this if you go to the ocean. So having water on our Earth is this great equalizer. It does control temperatures throughout the Earth to modify the extreme heating of the sun and the cooling when the sun's not there. How does that work in HVAC? Well, we can transfer more heat with water than anything else. So water has the ability to move very large amounts of heat in a very small volume. That's what its value is. Where I have a small pipe, water pipe, moving water, hot water, or cold water, it can be much smaller than, say, a duct that moves air. So that's its value to us for moving heat. It also affects almost everything we do in the HVAC industry. If I'm sizing an air conditioner in Arizona, and it's hotter than heck in Arizona, or I'm sizing an air conditioner in Louisiana. Okay, that air conditioner in Louisiana has a very different load than the one in Arizona. In Arizona, I may have a relative humidity of 5 to 10%, where in New Orleans I'll have a relative humidity of maybe 98%. That is going to make a difference in the sizing. The sizing in some of these highly humid areas can be half again what it would be for a low humidity area. That's one of the issues we have to deal with when we're air conditioning. Also in heat. When I have a furnace that is, say, 95% efficient, that means it's a condensing furnace. Okay, the condensing furnace is going to condense steam into liquid water. When it does that, it's going to release those 970 BTUs per pound that the condensation of steam would release. So by condensing the water, we're actually getting a lot of extra heat energy that we would not have gotten if we hadn't condensed the steam into water. Those are just some of the issues. I'm going to go over in the next weeks on these the charts for water and ice, steam, and what they actually mean for the HVAC industry. And so hopefully this will be a good series for those guys starting out in the industry, and every once in a while someone who's been in the industry for a while learns a little bit of something. That's it on this one.